I gotta chalk my wheel, disconnect my air line. I'll be on out to load me. I'm at the Bobcat here in Rogers, Minnesota. I got one stop in Jackson, Tennessee, one in St. Louis, one in Memphis. Not in that order, of course. I'm gonna disconnect my Red airline. Woo! Bust my booty. About 2 a.m. I'm a slacker here, doesn't want to get up. It's a rainy mess out there, but we're gonna roll out so we can get parking near our 90 so I can get all three drops made Monday. Fool out. Oh. Happy Mother's Day. Pouring down rain. Make sure nobody messed with my stuff. It's all looking good. Woo. It is a wet mess out here. Jesus. Get this deal done and get on down the road. Most of the rain's to the north of me, so hopefully I won't be in this crap long. There ain't not anybody else out here. Got the island to myself. Well, that's my total. Bad as that is, it's better than it used to be. She's ready to roll. Get in your seat, big rig. Get in your seat. Move over. She said, I'm tired of your driving. I want to drive this truck. I'm soaking wet just from the fuel. We're in Pacific, Missouri, and they've got the tornado warnings going off. Oh, jeez. The storm is about to move through. They said 60 mile an hour winds and hell, it'll bust your windows out. I'm not looking for any of that, but I can deal with 60 mile an hour winds. I do that in Wyoming all the time. But we'll see what it's gonna do. Well, Roxy got scared over there. She's a chicken. Tell them, say hey. Say hey. Say hello from Big Rig Roxy. We're just chilling in this thunderstorm. We're still in Pacific, Missouri. I'm gonna walk her one more time and then we're gonna go pull up and get some fuel and then head out and get this first Bobcat delivered. Whew. She kept me up half the night. So I look like crap. Away, and I'm gonna make this left and then try and get all the way over in the left lane with a line of traffic. We'll get over there somehow. Here we go. Jackson, Tennessee next. We were in and out of here 20 minutes. The Reaper Division. I don't think you can get checked in and get in the door in 20 minutes. Good job, Bobcat. Should have just backed up the road. It didn't look like it's like, do I go through the fuel island or do I
well now and I'll
without tearing anything up. That'd be easy enough. But I bet you've seen worse, huh? things a little bit easier on myself. That looked like too much work trying to get through there. Piece of day cab, but I only got a 48-foot trailer. But if I don't have to, I'd rather not. Next load, we're picking up at Ferguson in Nashville, and we're taking it somewhere in North Carolina. I didn't look at the details. It doesn't matter. I don't pick up till 7 o'clock in the morning, so I'm